Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to show you how to create a Swift D style track. Now he's produced for Schoolboy Q. He did the song Studio. He did 50 Cent's Animal Ambition track. He did some other work with Meek Mill. He did a lot of work, R&B, a lot of hip hop. So the definition of what Swift D does is that he caters to the artist. And this is how, you know, he doesn't have a quote unquote style. You know, you can ask, how do you recreate a certain track? But his style is based on the artist's history. And that's how you should be producing. When you send off tracks, you need to know who you're sending them to. Who are they for? Okay. And then you create from that perspective. Where do you see that artist going? Where do you see their brand going? What have they done in the past? What are their past successes? If you were to make a beat for 50 Cent after he released Get Rich or Die Trying, you would say, how do I make a beat like in the club? You know, how do I get my sound like that and continue that energy? That's what you should aim for. So this is a producer who clearly defines that. He's not locked into one sound, and he's transcended that block, you know, because there's one thing to have style and there's one thing to have your sound. Okay. And I think having a sound is a little overrated. But what you want to do to differentiate yourself is be able to get results. That should be your differentiator, to get the results that the artist is looking for, and also to have a sound to market, you know, to the artist. So that's two different sides of the coin. What that means is one's based on trust and skill level, and that they trust you to get what they're looking for. And then the other one is saying they're coming to you for what you do. So it's two sides to production. Anyway, moving on. But, you know, that's his approach in half these cases. It's not one sound that makes him him, you know, and I think that's very important. So let's just go over the G-Unit approach from Swift D's style. So he's bass heavy. I should probably write that as a note. You know, bass heavy, bass driven, of course, hip hop driven. So not a lot of live drums, a lot of sample drums. And for this style, we're going to be searching for a harpsichord, a Moog style bass. We're going to find some tom drums, maybe a subby kind of kick to kind of fill in the low end. We're going to try to find some Nolia trill kind of brass from session horns from Contact. We're going to see if we can find a bongo slash snare that kind of has that Islander feel. We're not going to get into guitar. We might pull up Omnisphere today. The Wurlitzer, we're going to pull up the demo of what's it called, Lounge Lizard. I just got that. And you know, get the bass rocking. Okay, so let's start from this checklist. Let's just work our way down. So a harpsichord, you can find that in Omnisphere. I'm not sure of any other plugins that have harpsichords per se, but it's that kind of English sounding piano that you hear in a lot of Travis Scott stuff. Well, not in a lot, in a couple Travis Scott songs. I'll pull it up from Omnisphere. There may be a harpsichord library in Contact. So you want to think Contact and Omnisphere for live instruments, okay? So let's click here. Let's go to keyboards. And let's go to type. And where are we at here? Let's try some clavinets first. Okay, so I moved my files. I totally forgot. So what I need to do is select Omnisphere only so we don't get that. That's the harpsichord type sound, but what I'm going to do is type it into the search function so it pulls up only harpsichord. But let's just keep searching real quick. So this is the sound, that bright kind of bitey sound. Okay, let's continue on. We're going for that kind of gritty, aggressive hip, a G-Unit feel. It's not very aggressive. Okay, so now I'm going to type in the search. Let's do harpsichord. I don't even know how to spell it. Harpsichord. And we only find one patch. Okay, so I'm going to end up using the first patch anyway. But you want to go through and search for sounds. So what I'm going to do now is clone this Omnisphere, and I'm going to pull up an organ, which I didn't list in that list before. And this is going to support the piano-ish aggressive feel. Okay, so this is clone now. And let's delete these extra patches. We don't need them. Let's go to organs. And you really want to think Hammond kind of churchy organs that have a lot of vibrato. That didn't have a lot of vibrato on it. That didn't either. That's the type of sound you're going for. That vibrato. Okay, so you can do little quick stabs like that and it sounds interesting. So that is, let me type that in, organ. So you can see how sound selection is half the battle. You need to know what sounds to get or to grab in order to build this track. So let's go into Moog synthesizers now. This might eat up the CPU, so I might overlook it for now, but let's crank up the audio just in case. Well, let me see. So anyway, there's a plugin called Reactor, and in Reactor, they have a library called Monarch. And Monarch is an emulation of a Moog bass. So let's go to player. And you'll see what the Moog kind of style is all about. Monarch, and double click, open up the ensemble. And here's Monarch. It's very CPU heavy. So again, these videos, you know, we have to reserve some CPU. So I'm going to turn this down. You can see the CPU is 7-8% already. And this is the heavy sound we get. What I'm going to do right now is just give it a shorter envelope. So I'm going to lower the sustain and give it a decay time. Also, I'm going to give the envelope, the filter, an envelope. So that's the bass you hear in a lot of dance music and also in the aggressive stuff. So we're going to use that Moog bass as the foundation for our bass. Let's look at some toms and some kick drums. Let's open up the drum samples tab. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Under Ultimate Producer Bundle 2, we gave out a free Fire drum kit. And let's go to kicks. Just find a kick that works. You don't want to get overly bassy because we can always add bass later. But just think texture when you're picking a kick. I like this kick, but I'm not sure if it translates into the headphones. So I'm going to turn down the monitor and my sub and listen over a pair of headphones. Okay, it translates pretty well. That's a very beefy kick. Has all the elements we need. Now let's get into the snare. So here's a, you know, the sound we want, kind of that 70s live snare sound. And we also can layer that type of snare over top. Here's another good snare you can use. You can layer it with that. So you got to be creative when you're getting into your snare arena and you want to layer as much as possible. We're going to layer a small clap. Layer that typical 808 clap, and let's pull out some toms. I don't think we have any toms in this kit, and let's also add a bongo. We do have a tom. Okay, cool. Oh, we even have vinyl. Okay, that's cool. So let's grab all this stuff. Okay, so cool, we have all the elements we need. Let's get into the next portion. Again, we're still in the sound selection, so we haven't even moved on to the rhythm yet. This is just pure sound selection. Bongo snare. We already got the bass. And let's go to the Nolia trill. So I mentioned Kontakt before for this. Let's open up the plugin database and pull out Kontakt 5. This is gonna have a library inside called Session Horns Pro. In Session Horns Pro, you have the, you can do solo or you can do performance. Let's try solo first to see if they have a trumpet or something we can use with different articulations of it. So let's try the trumpet. I'm not sure if it has different styles. Doesn't look like it. Looks like it only has one type of style. Or actually, here they are. Okay, so we can put it on vibrato, grace, growl. So these are all low key functions, which you need to go into MIDI to actually trigger these. So C1 is non-vibrato, D sharp 1 is grace. So to test that out, you know, we're going to look for like rips and growls. Let's try, what is a C1 going through G sharp? So let's X out of here, go to our channel rack, or click that button. We're going to give this horn a quick chord, like G major. Okay, it's a trumpet. It can only play one note at a time, huh? So it's not the trumpet ensemble. So that's the, okay, we're going to keep it at that. Now I'm going to test out the C1 and C2. So that's non-vibrato, I believe. C1. Okay, so when we get to C sharp, we should hear some pitch effects. So I'm going to hit shift up. Can't really hear a difference. So I'm not sure if this is even working here. Oh, you know what? These might be, I'm totally wrong. Oh no, key switches. Okay. I thought that says CC1. So if it says, for example, CC1, that's completely different. That's where you would go to your drop down for your, and you would go to browse parameters and you would scroll down until you see MIDI CC. Okay. So that's a different area. But I thought that's what it was saying for a second because I don't hear anything. So let's go to D1. So key switches. Oh, I guess you select it. Okay, why does it say D1? So we're on D1, aren't we? Okay, now I start to hear it. Okay, you hear that swelling of the volume? But we're going for a shaky kind of sound. That's cool. This is the type of sound we're looking for. E1, which is the grace vibrato. So let's hear the growl, which is F, and let's hear the rip, which is G1. So you want to cycle through these to test them out. So that's the sound we're looking for, F1. And then we can kind of accent it with G1. So we're looking for just quick notes with the F1 and then G1 at the end. So I'm going to already pre-templatize it with the, let's drag this out. But we're not going to hold the notes so long, okay? So now we have those notes in the bottom, so they're going to control that. So let's shorten the notes. So think little jabs like that. Now in performance mode, I want to stack these horns. So this one horn is not going to do what I want it to do, so I'm going to X out. I'm going to actually go to directory. Let's go back. Performance mode this time, because it allows us to have multiple stacks, and that's what we want. And it looks like it uses the same articulation technique, I believe. So it looks like you get to choose. I'm not sure if they tell you the buttons or not, or if it matters. Let's see. Okay, nothing changed. That means you probably have to select it off the bat. So it loads up a different library. So what that means, okay, there's a velocity sensitive threshold. That's pretty cool. So when it reaches over a certain velocity, it'll do this effect. That's a really cool feature. So let's try rips again. Okay, so this is even better. Okay, so now we have what we want. So these are the things you need to do. You know, if you don't have these samples, you want to look into it. You know, it's the only way you can get the sound that you're looking for most of the time. So let's change the brass stack to something older and more vintage sounding, less bright and more smooth tones. So let's go with smooth horns. Check that out. growl's a little too aggressive for me. Let's try Grace vibrato. We need a trill type of sound, so let's do trill. There we go. That's what we want. So you see how far we have to kind of research to get these sounds, you know, and that's from Kontakt in particular, called Session Horns Pro. You can get that from the Complete 10 Ultimate, or Complete Ultimate 10, whatever, you know, the version is, Complete 10 Ultimate. Guitar tabs, or guitar stabs, we're going to grab from Omnisphere. Again, I mentioned that before, but, you know, with Omnisphere, it doesn't sound so realistic all the time, so you want to be careful and only use it, you know, sparingly. But now you see how important it is to focus in on sound selection before you even get started. We spent at least 10 minutes trying to find these sounds, and this is exactly how long you need to spend and where you need to look for these type of sounds. Let's go to guitar type vintage and pull up just a regular baritone. Well, not a regular, but a... let's go bluesy. Just something to stick out. And let's grab the notebook. What else do we need? We need a Wurlitzer. So let's pull up the new demo version of Lounge Lizard. And let's go into the, where are we at here? Wurlitzer. Okay, we need that little bite sound. So let's close that up. So now we're ready to start. I know that was a lot, but that's how much, you know, focus you need to put into sound selection. A lot of people do not do that or take the time. So let's start with the drum rhythm on pattern 2. And let's just get a decent drum going with the metronome. Slow the BPM down to about 88 BPM. And when it says you have to stretch samples, you want to check all your drum samples. Now notice this kick says auto. We're going to actually click that and go to resample. Then you want to right click your time and go to none. Whoa, this kick is super loud. That's going to reset the kick. Okay, and that's important because it's gonna sound different if you don't. So check on all your samples, make sure it's not on auto mode. And just double check. Looks like it only did that for the kick. All right, so we're set as far as the samples go. So let's start with the kick and start with the snare. So just think G unit. You can add a little swing. So think boom, ch, boom, 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 ch. Or no, think boom, boom, ch, boom, boom, boom. So that snare is not tuned to the same frequency. It doesn't sound exciting. So I'm not going to use that right now. Let's use this, the other snare I have. Sounds more exciting and, you know, aggressive. So we don't have to do anything with the time. There's a pre-delay on the snare, so we don't have to worry about any time shifting. So that's great. Did I grab a hi-hat? It looks like I didn't. So let's go back to busyworksbeats.com, Fire Drum Kit, which is absolutely free, on the Ultimate Producer Bundle 2 page. We just need an aggressive sounding hi-hat. That'll work. So now that we have all our sounds, let's double click, highlight all of them, go to your mixer, right click insert one, channel routing. Route select the channel starting from this track. And let's add that hi-hat pattern. Now, generally, I wouldn't put the hi-hat with the snare, but in this case, I'm just going to keep it simple. We're going to right-click, fill each two steps. Let's take that swing off. So the hi-hat sounds, you know, a little too on beat, so let's go to the wrench, go to time shift. Add a little swing to it. Now also you want to give the hi-hat a little more realistic velocity. So let's go to the piano roll overview, open up piano roll, and we're going to go up, mid, down, mid. It's just a basic kind of groove you can use. So we're starting to get the G unit feel. So let's clone this pattern, and we're going to add a layer of this of the clap. So that's the only difference between this and pattern two. Now I'm going to lower the clap in the mixer so it's not so loud. And I'm also going to delay the clap so it's not directly over top of the snare. It has a little time to shine by time shift. So now you can hear the clap by itself. So let's go pattern two in the playlist. We're gonna right click, select pattern two, right click, select pattern three. So it's gonna go pattern two, pattern three. Let's go to song mode now. I'm gonna hit shift, left click and duplicate these and drag them over. So we want a little change up every 4 to 8 bars. So in this case, I'm going to do it every 8th bar. I'm going to click here, go to make unique. That's going to create another clone of pattern 3 into pattern 4. And I'm going to add some kind of tom fill like that. So let's go back to the pattern mode. Boom, boom, shh, boom. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So you can get rid of the kick so it doesn't, you know, take the attention off the tom. And then you can go click the piano overview, go to your tom, and we're going to give that a note value. So it wraps it up, right? So we want things like that to wrap things up. So now we're going to come up with a bongo kind of layer in a different pattern, pattern 5. See if that works. So we're going to create like a little bouncy bongo, and I'm going to lower the velocity, lower the fader, so it's not so evident. It's just going to be a little. Okay, so on pattern 5, we're going to create that little bongo texture. So I'm going to have it hit. Let's go to the mixer on track 10, pull this down. Okay, let's add this to the playlist. And where are we at? Let's hit play. So think dun, 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 dun. We can do it again. Bump, 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 bump. Okay, so now you can go to the piano roll and get your velocity right. So let's go to pattern mode. Quick technique you can do is click on your bongo, go to your envelope tab. We're going to shorten this bongo and make it very small and short. So lower your attack, lower your decay, lower your everything except the decay knob tab. We're shortening the decay of the bongo. Make it really short, okay? So let's hear it in context in the song. Can barely hear it. Now I'm gonna, you know, add an effect early, which is called let me think, what can we do? We can do stereo enhancer for this and use phase offset and pull it to the left. So it's kind of spread in left and right ear. Now for this one, I'm gonna make it unique. I'm going to edit the pattern and I'm going to create a little triplet roll at the end. It's going to go, you know, before we hit the end. Let's go to 1/3 step. I'm going to add 3 notes in here. And it's going to create a little rhythm that you really can't even tell unless you're really focused in on it. But that's going to be the difference there. So these are all, this is, pattern 6, and we're going to change this to pattern 5, which is the original bongo. So now we're going to clone these, bring them over, hit shift, left click, and drag. Okay, it kind of catches your ear and it restarts you. So now that we're done the rhythm, let's get into the instrumentation. Let's just make sure our checklist has been fulfilled as far as sound selection. So let's start with not a chord, but let's start with the bass. So some songs need chords to start them out, some songs don't. Let's start with the bass. I think this is the bass. No, bass is in Reactor. Okay. Okay, so here's the Moog emulation. So think aggression, don't think dancey kind of club. So think low and think an aggressive pattern. So maybe bum bum bum, ding 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 ding, ding ding ding. So I forgot to change it back to a half step. So a quick way to get an aggressive sound is to stay on the downbeat. Don't go in between the beats like 1, 2, 3, 4. Hit on those 1, 2, 3, 4 spots. That's going to add the aggression. When you start working your way in between, adding that boom, boom, ch, boom, 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 it adds like a clubby thing. Turn the swing meter up. That sounds goofy. Okay, so that's our bass line. So now let's clone this pattern and let's get rid of that last note so that we have one with the last note and one without. So pattern 8 is without, pattern 7 is with. So it kind of wraps itself up. So let's work on the cutoff filter. To add more aggression, I'm going to open up the filter a little bit to add more of that higher frequency. Add a little noise for aggression. Secret, a lot of people don't realize. See, the beat's already made. It's so aggressive and you can feel the G-Unit energy pouring out of it just from a bass line and from a drum rhythm. So what your goal from this point on is to add other elements and not screw that up. That's your goal, not screw that energy level up. So I'm going to separate this into 16 bars, but I'm going to start bringing in instrumentation around here and then make a variation here and then make another variation here. So let's start with the more of the Wurlitzer. Let's do that first, or the organ. It's not the organ. So we're gonna add little melodic things with the organ these last four bars. So let's go here, go to a new pattern, and I'm just gonna riff, figure out which keys work. That's all you gotta do. You don't really need to focus on your theory right now. You're just worried about the feeling of it. In that case, you would need to know theory for the chord I just created and why this is going to work. So it's a G minor, and then I move the minor note, which is the middle note, down one. So I'm going to show you that when I record this automation in score. Now notice how I'm using the chord at the end, you know, to wrap it up. I was testing out the chord to see if it'll work in between. Didn't really sound right, so I was just testing that out. But anyway, here's the chord. It's a G minor chord, which is G, A sharp, and D. And there, what I did was I transposed the one middle note down one to that next note down. So I'm playing the same chord. I'm just lowering the middle note, and it creates that horror-esque type of sound. Okay, so those all work. All you have to do is move the middle note. And let's fix the timing because there's a little lag. This is a little late. So is this, and it's not long enough. That's all you need. You don't need to dominate the whole thing with chords. Let's go to pattern 10. See if we can add this harp synth. Let's lower this in the mixer. Testing out notes to figure out a melodic rhythm. So I think we're gonna go dun 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 dun. Let's record that. You can see we're sticking to the aggressive tone, but I'm actually utilizing those in between sounds to kind of squeeze in some sound in there, you know, between the downbeats. Now what I want to do here, make it more realistic, a little delayed but not too delayed. So that's a little too early. Now also, I'm going to turn this down. I don't want this to stick out so much. Pan the organ to the right and turn it down. So again, you want to turn this down. You don't want it to get too, you don't want to take away. Again, we don't want to screw it up. Let's add that brass at this point. The brass is going to be similar to the actually, you know what we can do? We can copy and paste the organ chords, because that's going to be the same spot we're going to use the brass. So paste that into the brass, and I'm going to have the brass come in the last 8 bars. Now let's preview this. You can't even hear it. This is pattern 11. Can't tell they're there. So also, let's check the articulation, make sure it's passing that threshold and the velocity. So in this case, I want the grace vibrato. I think that's what, or no, we're gonna have the trill, and the notes are so short you can't really tell. So I'm gonna drag out some notes. I'm gonna drag out this first chord. To do that, I'm just gonna highlight it and hit Alt L, so it creates that tremolo because the note's long enough. No, trill, excuse me, not tremolo. So let's try trill whole. It's a little more aggressive on the vibrato effect. Let's do brass shake. What does that sound like? That's what we're looking for. There we go. Okay, so let's hear that and turn up the brass. Make sure it stands out. You can pan it left or right to make it stand out even more. There we go. And it even has that organish kind of vibrato effect. remember the organ's pan left or the right and the brass is pan left, so it's balancing out. And that's a perfect combo. Wow, it's great. Let's pan it a little further left. Solo this. I can't really hear it. Still sounds centered. So you want to pan as far as possible to make them both stand out. There we go. Okay. So these are little things that are going to make the sound work for you. Here's the guitar. We're going to definitely turn that down in the mix. So for the guitar, I'm just going to have it go. I'm going to have it hit and hold with vibrato right on the downbeat. So we're just going to hit A and just hold it. Okay, you can even add a wah to make it sound more bluesy. Let's add a wah effect. Let's go to Omnisphere, go to FX, pull up your effects, and go to Filter, Wah. We're going to set the rate to sync and turn it on about 1/4. So it has that wow, wow, and it sounds cooler. Now it's a little early on the wah, so what I'm going to do is go to the wrench, turn the time shift up so that the wah, when it goes wow, you know, it's hitting a little bit after the downbeat. Still a little early. There we go. Fits in the groove there. You can give that a stereo feel with the enhancer, just to pull it out a little bit more. Drag that note out a little longer. You can see how this starting to take away from the feel. So that's why you got to be careful with that stuff. Let's see what was here. Was it the Wurlitzer? So I'm just going to come up with little phrases, like, you know, little things like that to kind of make it interesting throughout the song. Excuse me. Is it automation and score? I kept doing it because there was a little error. I had an extra note in there. So I'm going to use the ending section here. I'm going to move that down. I'm going to separate these two. And let's move this down. Put this back up. Put this in here. Okay, just make sure we're on beat with the pattern 13. It's a little early, so instead of using the shift knob, I'm just going to manually go to snap to grid none and pull the MIDI over a little bit by hitting shift right 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that works perfectly. Now I'm going to give this some effects. Track 15 in the mixer. I'm going to give it some delay, ping pong delay. Set it to 4 measures and turn the feedback up. I'm going to grab these and use them every now and then. Let's go to bar mode. Make sure we're, deleting stuff. It's going to add that over here. Make sure the timing's right. That's all we have to worry about. Okay, so that's how you approach, you know, writing from the artist's standpoint in the producer's eyes, you know. So he's a producer you can look at to say how does he cater to the artist, because he's not just throwing out beats. You know, he has artists in mind before he does it, and that's how his style is developed. So that's why we teach you all these styles, so you can think of the artist first and then create the style, right? So take all these techniques and steps and ideas, sound selection and, you know, technique, and really cater to the artist. When you're making beats, I know some people make beats and they send it to like 30 people and they have no artist in mind. You really want to narrow that down, figure out who is it for, and send it to them. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.